Hi everybody and welcome back to Relax My Dog. Today's video is quite an important one and one that you guys have been requesting for quite a while, and that is how to toilet train your dog. So before I ramble on too much, as we know we can do that sometimes in the start of these videos, I'm just going to jump straight in. Now before I do get started, definitely do go down below and let me know basically a horror story about when your dog has not been toilet trained, because I know with this one I have had quite a few horror stories when we were toilet training him. I'm not going to get into it, but yeah, you can probably get the idea. But for now, let's get started. Now in this video, obviously Milo is an adult dog. He doesn't need toilet training anymore. He's fully toilet trained to the point where he will let us know when he even wants to go outside or just sit near the door and just look at the handle as if he wants to go out. So for today's video, we're going to be talking about some top tips on how to toilet train your dog. So things to take into account on when you are wanting to toilet train them. A lot of these tips are going to be very, very helpful to if you are about to toilet train, if you're in the middle of toilet training, or if you've just finished toilet training and you think that they are fully toilet trained. Now, before we get into the actual tips, it's important to know that toilet training doesn't happen overnight. It is something that takes quite a while for a dog to learn. Obviously, dependent on their breed, dogs like border collies learn really quick anyway. So he was quite a quick learner, fast learner with that. But other dog breeds can take quite a while. So do remember that this is a gradual process and it's not something to happen overnight, although some dogs can happen like that. And it mostly revolves around praise and not punishment. So remember that to praise the things that they do good and not to punish the things that they do wrong, if that makes sense. But we're going to get into that more within this video. Now, the first top tip is to make sure that you have a routine set in place before you do begin to toilet train your dog. Your dog will eventually begin to learn your routine when you get off for work, when you get dressed, when you leave the house, when you come back. They will eventually learn that sort of routine that you have. So make sure you stick to that. Make sure when you get up, you let them out for the toilet, you get dressed, you go back downstairs, let them out again. And if you do work away from home, then again, when you get home, make sure you are letting them out for the toilet training, and they will eventually hopefully learn your routine. However, if you do have a day off from work, which I know we all absolutely love, if you do get a day off, make sure that you are still getting up at that time to let them out. Don't be having any of these lions. Make sure you are letting them out at the right time, and also remember that they might need letting out in the middle of the night as well if you want to stay away from any accidents. So the second top tip is to make sure you have all of the relevant equipment on hand whenever your dog is toilet training. By this I mean, make sure you have toilet pads, newspaper, things like that. Make sure you also have like treats to give your dog if they are doing something right. If they go to the toilet outside, that is something to definitely praise your dog. So make sure you have the relevant treats. We have these little treats, which Milo absolutely loves. Milo, do you want a treat? Oh, good boy. Even though he's toilet trained completely, I still like to treat him a few. Number three is one that I didn't really think about when we were toilet training Milo, and that is to make sure you have a certain door in your house. This can be very, very confusing, but basically what I mean by that is if you have like 17 different back doors to the garden of your house, make sure you sort of choose and stick to one of them so that your dog knows whenever they go to that back door, they need to go out to the toilet. Whereas if you are sort of letting them out every single door, I mean, eventually they might learn that, but if you're letting them out every single one, they may not know that that is the toilet door that they need to go out at. So try and stick to one singular door so that they can just go straight out and go to the toilet. Number four is again one that you need to sort of continue doing, and that is to continue using the same terminology. By this I mean basically using the same vocab whenever you're speaking to your dog. For example, with Milo, we use, do you want to go for a wee wee? And Milo is able to recognize that that means that he needs to go outside, even though he can go for either one, a number one or a number two. Basically what that means is that your dog will eventually learn that wee wee means he needs to go outside and do his business. Whereas if you are going between wee wee, toilet, outside, your dog can get quite confused. So do stick to one of them. And actually it's known that some sort of guide dogs who are expertly trained can actually be told when to go to the toilet. They don't have to tell you. You basically tell them, you go, go on, go to the toilet. And they can learn that behaviour. You look so comfortable. Are you so comfortable? Can you see his tail wagging? Are you so comfortable? You are the cutest little boy. And then our last top tip, which is number five, is to let your dog out constantly. Even if it means having the door open during the summer, have it constantly open so they know they can just go in and out all of the time. Much like a cat when they just go out and do the business. It's very important that you do, if it's in winter and you don't want to have the doors open, that you are letting them out a lot of the time, just to make sure that even if they just want to go for a wander or a sniff, they know that, oh, they're going to let me out in like 10 minutes time, so it's absolutely fine, I can go then. Because obviously if you are not letting them out enough, they will be accidents, and then they might not learn thoroughly how to be toilet trained. And obviously if they do things outside and they go outside, then you can praise them with your training treats as well. But that is it for this week's video. Thank you so much for watching. Before you leave, don't forget to enter our t-shirt giveaway, which looks like this. It obviously says relax my dog on, so comfortable and really nice t-shirts, really good quality as well. All you need to do to win your very own t-shirt is pop over to Instagram, post a picture of your dog, and don't forget to tag us at relax my dog. And that's pretty simple, that's literally all you have to do. So definitely don't forget to do that before you leave this video. Also, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment, like I said earlier, and also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And me and Milo here, we'll see you next time. Bye.